I know what I'm doing, but I don't exactly understand my motivation. I'm not a bad person, but I'm not sure if I'm a good person. Do you feel the same way as I do? I often ask myself these questions. What do I want to do in life? Do I choose the correct path? Am I doing the right job? Did I choose the right partner? Am I happy with this life? How to be a better person than I am today? I think we need to know ourselves better in order to answer those questions. When I was younger, I was so obsessed with horoscopes, personality types, Chinese zodiac, and so on. There are tons of personality tests out there. They give you insight into who you are according to certain criteria. But what should we do about it? Let's get started. Art of Living, a Better Self. At first, I thought we are who we are born into. But there are people who are born with a humble background and even physically challenged, but succeed in life anyway. And then I thought that maybe the more we learn about the world, the more we are rich and fulfilled internally. But there are still many knowledgeable people with power who use their wisdom to destroy others. Afterwards, I think we are just the things we do. We are the community we serve. But this is not 100% correct either. Some people are doing good deeds with many kinds of intentions. Their intentions are not always nice. Long story short, I stumbled upon a record, Liao Fan's 四训, Liao Fan's 4 Lessons, a book passed down from the Ming Dynasty in China. Liao Fan was told by a Taoist monk that he would be alive until the age of 53 only and would not have a son. He proved that he could change his destiny so everybody could do it too. In the end, he lived a long life and had a son. He wrote this book especially for his son. This book contains his life stories of how to overcome our own destiny by cultivating kindness and humility. There are three conditions that we must fulfill before we can change or improve our own life. Number 1. We must have a sense of shame. I never thought about this before, but I think it is true that people who have a sense of shame and have a conscience most likely will not do bad things. I also thought that feeling shameful was a bad thing, but I was wrong. Feeling shameful can be good or bad. It depends on how we use our conscience. How do we use it properly? A righteous person would recognize that it is just as shameful to accept a large bribe as it is to accept a small bribe. He or she would refuse to accept either of them. At least, a person who feels ashamed to do bad things still has a chance to control his or her behavior. This feeling of approval and disapproval by feeling shameful is wisdom too. We are feeling ashamed of doing things that are bad. This is a good change in attitude. This is the first step. But be aware, if it is done for a long time, this way of change is very stifling because we are just toning down our behavior, but we never get to the root of the problem. This leads us to the next point. Number 2. We must have a sense of respect for others. So we don't do bad things not because of the law only. We don't do bad things because we respect other people's lives. Everybody has his or her own struggles to survive. If we respect other people's life, we will not bother to hurt others. A better way to reform ourselves is by understanding the reasoning behind. We must be cautious of our own intentions. For example, when something bad is happening to us, we release our anger towards other people who are unrelated. To change our temperament, We have to understand that everybody is different. People have their own strengths and weaknesses. We should learn to tolerate and respect others. Number 3. We must have the courage and determination to rectify our mistakes. Let's imagine a small mistake is like a wood splinter that needs to be removed from our skin. A big mistake is like a venomous snake bite. We need to remove the venom or the bitten finger as soon as possible, without doubt. When evil intention comes into our mind, we need to be aware and remove it immediately. If it's not possible, we must think about the reasoning why we should not do that. If we still cannot win with the reasoning, I recommend having a friend or family member who is trustworthy and willing to discuss things with us. After talking about our doubts, we will be able to organize our thoughts and come up with an answer. If not, maybe we just need time to be enlightened. As Mahatma Gandhi said, "Be the change you wish to see in the world." Well, the wise knows best. Let me remind you that this video is from my own experience and learning process of life. Please help to support this channel by clicking the subscribe button and the like button. Let me know what you think about this video in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Goodbye!